Chapel here for Emmanuel Evangelical Lutheran Church and School. My name is Pastor Joe Naumann. Today is December 2nd, 2020. Today I'd like to share with you a message of encouragement for your day-to-day walk with Christ. First of all, I'd like to ask you a question. Do you ever feel insignificant? Do you ever feel unimportant in the grand scheme of things? I think it's pretty easy for us to feel unimportant in this world of more than 7 billion people and how many celebrities are out there with how many followers and friends on Facebook and Twitter. And it can be easy for us to kind of feel like one little speck of dirt on this planet. And really, when you consider that our planet is just one little rock circling one star in the huge solar system and galaxy in which we live, and that this galaxy is just one small galaxy in the universe full of galaxies that we know of, it can all of a sudden feel pretty small, pretty insignificant and unimportant in the grand scheme of things. But we aren't to God, are we? That's something that we know for sure, that God is important to us, and that we are important to God, and that He cares about everything that goes on in our life. I was reading in the book of 2 Kings today, and these verses kind of struck me, and it strikes me just how almost unimportant or insignificant these verses may be, and yet to that individual's life, as we're going to read here, it really made such a huge, immense difference. So just two verses from 2 Kings chapter 13, verses 20 to 21 we read, "Then Elisha died, and they buried him. And the raiding bands from Moab invaded the land in the spring of the year. So it was as they were burying a man that suddenly they spied a band of raiders, and they put the man in the tomb of Elisha. When the man was let down and touched the bones of Elisha, he revived and stood on his feet." Two short little verses about this man who was brought back to life. Now remember, Elisha was one of the prophets of God. He was a prophet to the northern kingdom of Israel. He followed him immediately after the prophet Elijah. Following that was Elisha. Elisha did many miracles for the Lord, spread God's word, and warned people about the judgment that was to come. But eventually Elisha died, and he was buried. Elijah, of course, did not die. He went to heaven on that flaming chariot. But Elisha did die, and he was buried. And all of a sudden, there's this other man who is dead as well, and they're working on burying him. But all of a sudden, they're attacked by these raiding bands, the men who are burying him. And so they just dumped him quick in Elisha's grave, and simply by touching the bones of Elisha, he was revived. He was brought back to life. Now, we don't know this man's name. We don't know how he died. We don't know virtually anything about this man. And yet, for this man, this miraculous, amazing event, just not just for this man, but for this man's family, for his loved ones, for his friends, this amazing thing happened. As far as details go, this man is pretty insignificant in terms of the complete Bible history. There's lots of people we can think of who were raised from the dead. We can think of Lazarus. We can think of the boy at Nain. We can think of all those who were raised from death on Good Friday. But this man, we almost never think of in terms of people who were raised from death. And yet he was. And though it may be insignificant in the grand scheme of plan of salvation that God worked out from Genesis all the way to Christ's death and resurrection on the cross, and eventually to us returning to heaven to be with the Lord forever, it may seem insignificant, but this man, this was everything. This was his life here on earth. All of a sudden, he went from death to coming back to life. It may seem small, but to this man, it was everything. That's how God works for us in our lives as well, too, doesn't it? We may be nothing but a blip, a footnote in the pages of history, but to God, we are important. To God, the things that are happening in our lives are absolutely vital. And that's why God encourages us and tells us to bring everything to Him in prayer, to bring everything to Him in supplication, and to allow our innermost thoughts and hearts to be revealed to Him, because He matters to us. We don't know this man's name, and think about how many other people through the history of the world, we don't know their name. But what's important is that God knows your name. You are written in God's book of life, that your name is inscribed on His hands, as we learned about in a sermon a couple of weeks ago, that God treasures us, that He keeps us, that He guards us through this life. That's what's really most important. Not whether or not the history books record your name, but whether or not God records your name in the book of life. And the reason why your name can be recorded in the book of life is because God showed his great love for you through his son, Jesus Christ. You know, Jesus at one point in his ministry says, you know, God has all the very hairs on your head numbered. He says that not a sparrow falls to the earth, not a bird dies that God's not aware of it. And he says, you are so much more valuable to God than some bird or some animal. God intimately knows every detail of your life, every scar, every hair, every difficulty, every challenge, every tribulation that you've been through. God knows. And though it's not going to be recorded in some history book for all generations, for everyone to remember forever, God knows. God remembers. And God cares. And he wants you to know that he cares deeply for you. So no matter what you go through, no matter what trials or struggles you may face in this life, remember that God cares for you, that you're not some blip in the history books to him. You are his own dear child. You know, I think of my own children, and I know so many details from their life. I know just about everything that's happened to them in their lives because I care deeply for them. The people that we care the most for, we know the details of their lives. We know their birthday. We know the different things that have happened to them. We know how many times they've been to the dentist. We know, on and on. We know the details of their lives because we care. God knows the details of our lives intimately because he deeply and lovingly cares for you and for me and for all people. He knows the day we died, the day we were born. He also knows the day we were reborn, when that baptism worked in our hearts, the washing of regeneration, the renewing of the Holy Spirit. He knows the day that we're going to die, the day he's going to take us to heaven to be with himself, unless he comes again first to judge the living and the dead. Jesus cares deeply for you. So this man in 2 Kings chapter 13, we don't know much about him, but we pray that he trusted in God as his Savior, that this event where he was brought back to life by simply touching the bones of Elisha, we pray that this led him to a stronger faith, that trusted in the Lord, and that led to everlasting life. But eventually, he died too, again. Eventually, you and I too will be left to the pages of history unless Christ comes again. But what's important is that we are known by God. And as we look forward to that last day of judgment, that we will know God even as we are known by God now in time. And so we look forward to that great day of deliverance, that great day when Christ will bring us to be with himself once and for all. And there we will see God eternally. Let's pray. Lord Heavenly Father, we thank and bless you once again for your great love shown to us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Jesus, who was dead but is now alive again. Jesus, who is the firstborn of those who have died. Lord, thank you for that great gift of love that he showed to us through his perfect life, his death on the cross, and through his resurrection. Thank you for bringing him to heaven, where he is even now preparing a place for us that he may come again and bring us to be with himself forever. Help us to know that though our time here on earth may be insignificant in the pages of history, it is very important to you that you love and care for each one of us and are intimately involved in every aspect of our lives. Help us to remember that and help us to bring our hopes and prayers and thoughts to you in prayer on a daily basis. Finally, Lord God, we pray that you would be our guide and our strength through this life. Lead us unto the way everlasting and bring us to heaven to be with you. We pray all these things in your saving name, and we pray as you have taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom of God.